and thanks for joining us. I'm Laurel Hess, and this is Comcast Newsmakers coming to you from the State Capitol Building in downtown Lansing. Our topic today is transparency in campaign finance. Joining us now to talk about it is State Senator Steve Beda, a Democrat from the 9th District, which represents the southern portion of Macomb County. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Well, thanks for having me on today. It's always a pleasure.
And you are in the midst of, you have introduced a bill that would help with some campaign finance reform, at least on the state level. What are you proposing?
Exactly. Well, some people might be familiar with 527s. It's a section of the IRS code that allows for money for expenditures for advocacy of certain issues. There's also a case that a lot of people have probably heard of, is the Citizens United versus the Federal Elections Commission. The two individually brought up an issue that's been growing in concern amongst those that are interested in transparency in government and in elections, and it's the influence of this large unregulated amount of money coming in from corporations and unions that go into influence state elections. 527s are often used for influencing federal elections in which there's a reporting requirement, but there's no such reporting requirement for contributions to influence state elections. This bill that I've introduced, Senate Bill 815, would allow for those organizations that utilize a 527 to publicly report what elections those are being used.
So you're not saying that unions or large corporations should be limited or should not be able to contribute. You're just saying that all of us should know that they are.
Exactly.
And then on the other end, that the folks receiving the money should be reporting what they're doing with it?
Exactly. And sometimes it's not going directly to a campaign committee. It's a soft money, so there's money spent independently of that campaign committee. The problem is the public doesn't know where that's coming from, and the public doesn't know who's paying for those commercials. So there's some shadowy group in the background that's trying to influence elections through expenditures of oftentimes millions and millions of dollars, but the public has no right to know. And under this bill, that would change that, would allow a lot of transparency into the process, which I think we want for clean elections in the state of Michigan.
And so at what point after you get this passed do you create a website that we can all go to and see? Because it may be out there through a FOIA request and you have to go search and find out, but how do you make that information really easily accessible to the public?
It would actually be required to be reported on the website, similar to our campaign committees. Now, if you go to the Secretary of State's website, for example, you could hit on elections and it'll take you to a number of sites where campaign committees are required to report, and you could find my committee if you wanted to and find out how much expenditures my committee did for election purposes, as you can for any other elected official in the state of Michigan. The 527s right now don't have any similar reporting requirements or transparency requirements.
And I guess I always assumed that there was some sort of a limit, or, you know, that if I wanted to contribute to a candidate or to a certain organization that was raising money for a political stance, that I might be limited as an individual. $1,500, that's as much as you can give.
Well, there are state campaign limits that you could do for state campaign committees, but there was this Citizens United case we had a couple years ago in which it opened the floodgates in some other type of committees, such as a 527, and how much money that they can expend on the advocacy for a federal candidate or against a federal candidate, as well as for state candidates. And again, what we're trying to get to is that 527, that shadowy money that's coming from somewhere but the public doesn't know where, trying to influence elections. And we just want to make it transparent. Open up the doors, let in the light, let's clean up elections in the state of Michigan.
Well, and nobody should be able to argue with that. So everybody should know where their money's being spent and how it's being spent. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. It's always a pleasure.
Thank you. Today's Comcast Newsmaker was State Senator Steve Beda, a Democrat from the 9th District.